Good evening, everyone, and welcome all of you to the 8th session of the Week of Prayer, the PM session. And I'm so proud to say that the speaker today comes from the College of Education. She is Tabu Klein, and she brought us an interesting message today. She really touched our hearts with her words, with the words that came from God. And that's why I would like to introduce her to you. She's Jean Tabu Klein from the College of Education, English major. And our student...
And to join us as well for this evening is our brother from the College of Nursing and is currently on his fourth year in his chosen program, Brother Nehemiah. Thank you very much for granting us this opportunity to have this interview with you this evening.
Thank you so much, as what my classmates said. Now let's start with the first question to our student. And I would like to ask you, please tell us, what experience you have gotten from the message today? What insights or what reflections have you gotten from this important message, such as success, a step forward?
The lesson today was very intriguing and so beautifully presented. There were many lessons we can learn, but what stood out to me personally was that in order to achieve success, we must take a step of faith. Just like the priest who carried the Ark of Covenant had to take a step of faith into the River Jordan before he parted ways.
Thank you so much. That's actually the truth. If you do not move forward, how can you expect something to happen? And our speaker today, Jean Tabu Klein, was saying that so many people expect to happen something first for them to move forward. And the actual reality is that we have to move first, we have to show our faith first, and then receive the blessings from God.
Thank you very much. You had mentioned that for years you were only supporting from the sidelines, from being an usher and a part of the program team. Can you share how did you come to the decision of finally accepting the call to become the speaker? How did you prepare for this event? Are there any difficulties or walls that had set you back?
I believe that since this is a part of my ministry, and since this is the part, this is a part of my prayer for those 5 years in Week of Prayer ministry. And I know in my heart that when they will call me to minister as the Week of Prayer speakers, I will say I will go. And then for the preparation, it has been so tough. I've procrastinated a lot, really. And for my manuscript, it took a while. After I really finally finished that, and I revised and revised and revised until God had put enough words, the right words for me to share in our congregation.
We praise the Lord that you have finally accepted the call.
Thank you so much, Jean Tabu Klein. And now the second question before the last, I'd like to ask you, now that you learned those insights, those experiences, or those reflections, I'd like to ask you, you as a nursing student or particular, how would you apply those lessons in your daily life?
I think this lesson can be applied to not only to us nursing students, but also to everyone in general. We must remember that in every situation we're in, before we face challenges, we should put God first. The same way the Ark of Covenant was placed ahead of the Israelites and they were able to part the River Jordan, it's important to remember in our daily lives that every day before we wake up or after we wake up, we should pray and communicate with God and read His scriptures so as to set away our filthiness and set God first in our lives.
Thank you so much. That's actually true. If you do not show anything in your daily life, you have to really focus in your day, what you are doing every day. What are you doing for Christ? What are you doing that shows that you trust God? Thank you so much for that.
You had just delivered such an inspiring message. And if there is one thing you hoped to move forward for our fellow brothers and sisters, what is it?
I believe in my heart that whenever there is this Jordan or this wall of Jericho in your heart, just trust that Jesus already overcome this world, that Jesus is the origin of success. And we can know that since He is the origin of success, that He already overcome this world as His children, as His sons and daughters, we can too.
Amen. I am confident that with your message this evening, we are able now to crush these walls of Jericho. So now...
Now, my brother Nehemiah, I have for you the last question for this very short interview. And it is, what would you say to the students who are unwilling or who are maybe a little lazy to come to a week of prayer? What do you think they are missing?
I would say to those students that you're missing out a lot if you choose to not attend the week of prayer, because this is really a spirit-filled program that could be life-changing to anyone who attends. The devil always tries to put distractions in our way to make us feel like we don't need to fellowship with God. But it's important to remember that this is very important in our lives as Christians. It will lead to spiritual growth and also success, as today's lesson says.
Thank you so much, Nehemiah. That's really, really interesting that we shouldn't just focus on our academics, but our spiritual life is also important for all of us. It builds our character and it helps us in our everyday.
Thank you. To end our interview for today, if there is one thing that you wanted to pray for in behalf of our brothers and sisters, what is that impact or effect that you prayed to achieve during this event?
All I really prayed hard for the Lord is for His moving hand to move, that for His words to be uttered from my mouth. That is the only prayer that I want, that I don't want to take the credits, that may it be that the Lord will take away my filthiness, my selfishness in my heart, that whatever words that I will be delivering, it's gonna be from Him. And with all the preparation and the prayers and those people who have shown their support and prayer to me, I really praise God for that.
Thank you. We all pray that your prayers will be heard. Thank you very much for granting us again this opportunity to interview you guys.
Yeah, thank you so much. And I think that the best output of this sermon was that many students have brought their lives to Christ. They decided for Christ. They moved forward, not just one step, but they decided the best decision. They took the best decision of their lives to bring their lives to God. So thank you so much, everyone, for accepting this very short interview. God bless us all.